You have some awesome visuals inside your Jupyter Notebook or your Python script, and now you want to put that together into one cohesive PDF that you can present to your stakeholders. Now, you can do this inside a Jupyter Notebook, just NB convert and whatever go from there, but it doesn't really look that amazing. I've seen a handful of other options out there, and they all are kind of hit or miss. What I've loved from the R ecosystem is R Markdown, and I recently found out about Quarto from Brian Julius, and this has been amazing for me. This is what I've been using to output my homework files in my current certificate program. Today I'm going to give you a demonstration in Python what that looks like. So let's head over to Visual Studio Code and we'll take a look at my example document here. As you can see, these Quarto documents are pretty similar to what you'd be looking at inside a Python notebook. However, instead of obvious set-aside cells, these cells are more like a flowing text document. So we see at the top here, this is all of our information telling us how we're initializing the file. Next, we jump down to all of the little pieces that I would be using to set up my information for the report. And right here, echo false. This is telling us that we're evaluating this information, but we don't want to display this information. This is telling us that after our table of contents, we're going to our new page. Then I go through the executive summary. We have our little demonstration here for our LaTeX table. You can use Markdown tables as well. I've just been using LaTeX because it's been a little easier for my reports. Inline code isn't supported for Python, so the workaround that I found is to write something out in a way that's going to be evaluated with this markdown function. Then we have our plots along with the captions that go alongside those. There are a lot of different formatting options that you have within Markdown. You also have the ability to add some additional things like HTML tags or some other things that are talked about in the documentation. Then lists are pretty simple in Markdown. This is something that I love about Markdown and one of the reasons that I like using this to output documents. One of the other really cool things about this is that you're able to dynamically update your charts or your code that's being generated to generate your numbers. And then that way, you're not having to go copy paste a whole bunch of individual numbers all over the place and hope that you got them correct because they're automatically being updated for you. So you can save this file as you go along. In Mac here, it's Command S to save. And then once you're ready to render your document, it's Command Shift K. And this one's going to be pretty quick, only about 30 seconds or so to render. Once your document renders, it will open a preview for you, and you can see what this looks like right here. You have your table of contents, you have your dynamically updated date, you have your executive summary with all of these links that are active, you have your table here with the title, and you can reference it later on, you have your points that you wanted dynamically updated, and you can see that you're able to put equations in here as well. These charts look really good when you plot them out this way. You're able to zoom in on them, and you don't have pixelation artifacts, which is really cool. And you don't get that if you copy paste your chart out into something else. And then of course you have all of your formatting down here as well. There's a lot that we can talk about with reports. So if you have any questions, please leave those down in the comments and I look forward to chatting with you there. To the stars!